June Oberg was born on June 12, 1917, and now, at 100 years old, she is the matriarch of our family. We call June Oberg our sweet Mama June. And when I sat down and asked Mama June what event shaped her the most in her whole life, she immediately said it was the day she became a Christian.
Born, I guess it was 1950 when I became a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, that changed my life. Well, I had been taught, not necessarily the Bible, but I had been taught the principles, how to act. Anyway, all the Bible meant to me was just the stories.
Mm-hmm.
They were just stories. And when I, after I was baptized and started going to the Church of Christ, well, I learned the Bible.
Mama June told me that when she learned the Bible, she learned the truth behind her favorite verse, John 11:25-26, that if she believes in Christ and gives her life to him, she will have eternal life. Since this decision, Mama June has had 6 kids, each of which having many kids of their own. She has become the matriarch of a huge family tree, and each person in that family tree has been shown the truth that God's love is eternal. My dad likes to say, when he enters heaven, he hopes that he will see a sea full of Clydes, and he likes to visualize so many Clyde family members that have given their lives to Christ that he cannot see the end of us. He tells us that that sea of Clydes is possible because of Mama June. When I asked Mama June about the second event that shaped her life, she told me that it was when her husband was denied access into the military during World War II. She explained to us that her and her family lived in South Texas and were farmers. When her husband tried to enlist, he was told that his crops were too crucial to his community and they couldn't afford for him to leave and go fight.
He tried his best to enlist, but they wouldn't take him, because he was keeping 5 counties of farming equipment going. And they kept telling him he was doing more good right where he was, but it didn't make him happy.
Did it make you happy that he stayed?
Well, yes, it made me happy.
Mama June told me about how happy she was that her husband was right next to her during the scary times of World War II. But more importantly, she talked about how important it is to find someone to share your life with that you love and are devoted to. My dad also tells me that he was raised knowing that you have 2 major important decisions in your life. The first one is committing your life to Christ, which Mama June told us about. The second one is committing your life to someone else, if you choose so, that will guide you in a path towards Christ and will take care of you and love you to the best of their abilities. My dad was raised knowing this, and he raised me knowing this. And I see now that all of this stems from Mama June and her great love for Christ and her great love for her husband. It's kind of funny that this project was assigned the year of Mama June's 100th birthday. We threw her a big birthday party this summer, and I didn't really know how much I should appreciate my Mama June. Through this project, I've realized how my Mama June has led my family down a path that Christ is the center of, and that Mama June's love for her husband has flowed through her family all the way down to me, her great-granddaughter, and I can see that a woman of God who values family and Christ first is one to be respected.